So anyway, Madden, the game, we know is big amongst not only gamers, but football players love it too. And it turns out that you may not believe it, but there is a connection between the game and the game. As in the video game and the actual football game and what it is. And we wanted to find out what that connection is. So we spoke to Liel Leibovitz. He's an assistant professor at NYU and a researcher into video games. And we said, okay, Liel, like, what's the deal? What is the connection here between Madden the video game and actual NFL football?
I think it's safe to say that actual football, sports football, has definitely had an effect on how Madden has developed throughout the years. But as far as I understand, it's your take that Madden has had a bigger effect on actual football?
I would say that's exactly the case. You know, you are seeing, I'll give you an example. I'm watching this game, the first game of the 2009 season. It's the Broncos versus the Bengals, I believe. And Brandon Stokley makes this incredible catch, like 20 or something yards. And he's right there on the end, you know, on the end zone. There's 16 or 17 or 20 seconds left in the game. And rather than just crossing to the end zone and score a touchdown, he makes a sharp right turn and he runs along the line just to run down the clock. And I'm watching this and I'm thinking to myself, you know, wow, he's playing Madden. You know, that is something that I've done in that video game, you know, hundreds of times.
Me too.
And after the game, you know, people asked him, you know, were you essentially doing a Madden move? And he said, yes, that's exactly what I was doing. You have all these players now that have grown up with the game, spent hundreds of hours playing it, and that actually proved to be like an amazing training simulation for them.
That is actually quite an amazing story. I can't imagine that day one he picks up his first copy of Madden, and then the next day, okay, well, I'm playing an actual game, let's do it. Did he say how long it took him to get the courage up to start to use Madden in his actual gameplay?
Well, no, I think it's even more profound than that. You know, if you're a kid like that, and I think virtually every NFL player and probably most coaches are in this position. You know, you're 6, you're 7, you're 8 years old. You pick up a copy of Madden, and look, football is to a great degree like every sporting game is a game of skill, right? And it's also a game of luck, but to a very great degree, it's a game of strategy. So you're 6, you're 7, you're 8, you pick up Madden, and you play these plays, you know, a dozen, 100, 1,000 times. By the time you actually pick up a real pigskin and get on the real gridiron and you're a professional football player, you've already experienced these things in theory, but still, you have them kind of, you know, burnt onto your mind's eye. And, you know, that gives you the courage to experiment.
I've heard something along those lines with race car drivers as well, who use the racing simulators based on whatever series they're in to learn the tracks before they get to the track, if that makes sense.
Definitely. And look, this was, I think, Madden's brilliance, was understanding. I don't know if he knew it or intuited it, that video games have a tremendous capacity of serving as simulators. They were developed by the Army, and the Army's idea was understanding that, you know, war games have existed for, you know, 200 years before computers came along on pen and paper, used by armies all over Europe. And they were great because all they really did was give you the ability to statistically analyze the likelihood of various scenarios, you know, given all kinds of changed conditions on the field, which is very helpful if you're planning or strategizing or thinking or trying to simulate war, and obviously very, very helpful if you're trying to think or strategize football. So Madden came along and said, this was in 1984, if you want me to put my name on this game, I'm not going to do some cutesy thing where you just have little figures that kind of look like real-life athletes running around. I want it to be a genuine, honest-to-God 11-on-11 football with all the strategic components that go into the game itself.
If that's the case, then, what do you believe, or at least what's your feelings on the Madden curse and how that affects just football in general?
Wow, the Madden curse. You know, you would need a rabbi or a priest, not a video game scholar, to answer that. You know, I honestly don't believe that it's real. I think, and if it is real, it's certainly not the Madden curse. Like, all Madden is, all the cover of Madden is an indicator that a particular athlete is very popular, which means that a particular athlete is under a lot of stress because of high expectations, which means that the potentialities for said athlete to screw it up and disappoint his fans and teammates is very, very large. I think that's just normal human progression. I don't think there's some sort of mystical voodoo attached to the John Madden franchise.
I should mention that we're talking to Liel Leibovitz, who is a video game researcher at New York University. We're talking about the effects that not actual football has on the Madden video game franchise, but how the Madden video game franchise is affecting football in general, and also the big game that's coming up later today. Liel, I just want to ask you, do you have a favorite? I know that everybody with a console these days can simulate a game of Madden and just see who is going to win the Super Bowl. Do you have a favorite right now based on your research?
A favorite for the Super Bowl? You know, let me make a really kind of, you know, shameful confession. I was a fanatic, avid Madden player for years. I dropped the game about 2 or 3 years ago because it just got too complicated for me. It's gotten to the point where you really have to be, you know, almost a semi-pro to even get it going. I will still, you know, kind of like whip out the console today and probably play the game. I'm personally, you know, rooting for the Broncos. But you know, the Madden franchise has really left me behind. It's just gotten too much.
That's an interesting thought there. I wonder how long it's going to be before only people who actually play actual football in the NFL, or, you know, maybe college football as well, will be able to play Madden because it has surpassed everybody else.
Well, you know, I personally think that's a great question, and obviously a question that I think EA, who makes the game, is you know, they're asking themselves the same thing. But I think there's also something else here. Look, I've now kind of gravitated towards this stage of my life where I have, you know, a wife and 2 small children, and so investing the kind of time in a video game that I could, you know, easily invest 5 years ago now is kind of an odd justification for me to make. So I think it also has to do with demographic. I think probably for young players coming into it right now, this amazing degree of control over every little aspect of the gameplay and strategy is probably very thrilling. I don't necessarily think EA has anything to worry about.
Well, I do continue to play the Madden games for this show as every iteration comes out, but I will admit, I kind of miss the days of Joe Montana football on the Sega Genesis, and I'm...
Yeah, me too!
And I have to wonder out loud, I wonder how pissed off Joe Montana is after, even when his game was first coming out, they had to get the guys working on Madden to come and help them out to get that game out the door. So given everything that's happened, I wonder how pissed Joe Montana is.
Well, I don't exactly know the history. I think Wired magazine did a really, really nice piece about it. I remember there being some sort of story along the lines of, you know, yeah, exactly as you said, the people who did Madden also being involved with the Montana game and just having kind of like a dual loyalty conflict of interest thing going on. But I don't think Joe Montana should be that pissed, or the people, obviously, you know, more likely that created this franchise should be pissed, because, you know, Madden's triumph is very specific, and it's specific because it offered the opposite, because it offered this great level of intricacy, and it's just one in the marketplace. You know, there'll always be a market for people who just enjoy a quick, fun game, but I think what the medium could really do, what video games the medium could really do that nothing else could do, is really give you this intricate, amazingly detailed simulation. And I think this is what people have gravitated towards.
Well, Liel, you are an assistant professor at New York University. You're also a video game researcher there. But as far as I understand, you're also a writer. You got a book coming out, and it's about video games?
It is. It's called God in the Machine, Video Games, a Spiritual Pursuit, and rather audaciously it argues that far from being an empty waste of your time, video games may actually have some redeeming moral qualities.
So that is Liel Leibovitz, assistant professor at NYU, who does some researching into video games, talking about the connection between Madden, the video game, and actual football. Interesting.
Yeah.